In this example, I want to have a drop-down list here. It must give me a drop-down list with these names. And when I choose that, the correct department must be pulled through from my master list. So firstly, the drop-down. So I'm going to highlight these cells, go to data, data validation. I'm going to tell it to look for a list. I'm going to tell it where that list is. So I'm going to highlight these. If they're on another sheet, you can go to that sheet and highlight it. When I say OK, you'll see each one now gets a little drop-down box. When we click on it, we can choose our person. To now make it look up based on that, we're going to use a VLOOKUP. Could use an XLOOKUP as well. So we're going to use VLOOKUP. And all we're going to say, it's asking where's the lookup value? Look in that cell there, no dollar signs. Where must it find the answers? So over here, so you must highlight this plus anything you plan to bring through. And as a rule, these should be dollar signed. So I'm going to just push my F4 key, make sure the dollar signs are on all the letters and numbers. What column must it bring through? Column index number. The way Excel counts in VLOOKUP, that's column one, that's column two, because that's the area we highlighted. So this is going to be a two. And the range lookup, very important. Type false, because we want to find exactly the correct name. And when I say okay, we can say Ben, it pulls through B. Just going to highlight this. Now at the moment, these are saying NA. That's because there are no blanks. We can go and choose another person and it'll pull it through. To avoid these NAs, just in front of the VLOOKUP, I'm going to go if error open bracket and at the very end put a comma and then just two inverted commas next to each other and close it. Copy it, paste it, and there we can now look up and the department will appear.